B.Tech final year students, and we are currently pursuing the PG diploma course at Kernel Masters as our final 8-semester training. So at the end of the training, we had to make a project, so we made an industrial IoT gateway. So this video will be divided in two parts. In the first part, I'll just go through this presentation and give you an introduction about this project. In the next part, I'll give you the demonstration. So the aim of this project is to develop an industrial IoT gateway running a Linux kernel which can pull any number of nodes for temperature and humidity data and upload it to the MySQL database server using MQTT protocol. So this is the block diagram of the whole project. In the center we have gateway which runs on BeagleBone Black. Now BeagleBone Black uses AN335X processor which uses a Cortex-A8 core, and the gateway supports two protocols, RS-485 and ZigBee. On the node side we have a TM4C microcontroller node 1 supports only ZigBee protocol which is wireless, and node 2 supports only RS-485 protocol. Now the job of the gateway is to poll each of these nodes for their data, in our case it is temperature and humidity data, and then upload it to the server. And on the node side, the job is to wait for the gateway request, and as soon as the request is received, get the temperature and humidity data from the sensor and send it back to the gateway. So suppose if gateway wants temperature information from node 1, it will send this data through both RS-485 and ZigBee, and the node 1 on receiving responds back with the temperature value. So after the gateway receives this information, the next job of the gateway is to publish this information to the MQTT broker, so that subscriber on the other end of the broker receives this data and uploads it to the MySQL database server. After that, a web page can read this server information and display it to the end user. So how MQTT works is that there are three parts mainly: publisher, broker and subscriber. Publisher is essentially the source of the data, in our case it is gateway, and subscriber could be anyone. It could be local or it could be just about anyone, it could be in the cloud also. So coming to the left side of the screen, now gateway has a lot of configuration parameters like the number of nodes, polling interval, and what all protocol it supports. It could be ZigBee, RS-485 and maybe more, and what is the MQTT host ID and IP address. So all of that data is stored in the configuration file. Now to make this configuration file more user interactive and accessible, we also made an Android app. Now the job of this app is to get the data from user and upload it to a Firmware server. Firmware server is nothing but Google Cloud. And on the gateway we have a Python script running in the background. What that script does is it reads if there is any change in the server, it reads that information and updates the configuration file. And the main C code running on the gateway then takes these changes into account and updates its own parameters.
Now talking about the Kernel Masters protocol, the gateway communicates with the node via the following protocol. First is the start signal and then the ID of the node, to which node it wants to send the request, and then the function code, that is temperature for T and humidity for H, and finally the stop code. Now the gateway sends this packet to the node, and the node on receiving this packet check corresponding the node ID and checks the function code. So suppose it receives T, it calculates the temperature from the DHT level sensor, and then after calculating the temperature, it sends the following packet to the gateway. First the start signal, then the ID of its own, and then the function code T for temperature, H for humidity, and the data, that is temperature and humidity data, and then the stop signal. For example, gateway wants to send node 1 a request to calculate its temperature and to get its value. So the gateway will send the starting character 1, T, and then the ending character. The node on receiving it will check its node ID 1. If the node ID is 1 and if it is node 1, then it will see the function code. If the function code is T, it will take the temperature value, and then after that it will send starting character 1 T, and suppose the temperature character is 30 degrees suppose, and then stop ending character. So this is the packet format for sending and receiving the temperature and humidity.
Currently in our IoT architecture, there is one gateway and two nodes. So you can have a look at this gateway. This gateway has a BeagleBone black, and this is the Kernel Master embedded Linux development board, and this is the XB module, and this is the MAX485 chip which converts the UART signals to RS485 signal, and this is the RS485 cable which is then connected to the node 2. This is the firmware development board. This is the Tiva C series launch pad which has a TM4C123 microcontroller, and this node has a sensor, DHT11 sensor, which reads the environment variables like the humidity and the temperature, and this node only supports RS485 protocol. Similarly, node 1 supports only Zigbee protocol, rest everything is same. Same sensor, same everything. So this is connected wirelessly and this is connected wired. So now you can take a look at the gateway LCD. Gateway is polling first node 1 temperature, node 1 humidity, node 2 temperature, and node 2 humidity. So the current configuration in the Android app is set up like this. The number of nodes are 2, polling time is 5 seconds, and both Zigbee and RS485 protocols are enabled because one node supports RS485, one node supports Zigbee. So the job of the gateway is to get the data from the node and then publish it, then finally reaching to this web page. On this web page you can see there are two devices, device ID 1 and 2, both are active with their corresponding temperature and humidity values. Now suppose in our current IoT architecture we want to add one more node. Let's say this is the node 3. Everything is same and it only supports RS-485 protocol. First we connect the power to it, and now I will connect the RS-485 cable to its RJ45 jack and switch it on. Now as you can see, the gateway again starts polling from node ID 1, temperature, then humidity, then node 2, same, and now it goes back to node 1. Why? Because we haven't informed the gateway about addition of the new node. To do that, we need to update the configuration file, and for that we use this Android app here. In this Android app, current number of nodes are 2, so we change it to 3, and say we also reduce the polling time to 3 seconds, and we don't need to change this because the new node supports RS-485 protocol, so and that is already enabled, and we update. So RS-485 protocol can support up to 128 devices. So currently we are only using 2 devices with RS-485. So now that I have updated this information, after a while you can check this updated information on the web page. So now as you can see, the node 3 is active, and the temperature and humidity values are 28. Here you can see after node 2 we start polling the node 3 also. Now the cycle will be node 1, 2 and then node 3, and when we pull node 3 it gives the temperature and humidity data. Right now it is giving the temperature data as 38 and humidity as 33. Now suppose that one of our node goes offline. Suppose our node 1 goes offline. So now the gateway will try for 5 times. It will poll the node 5 times. If it doesn't reply these 5 times consecutively, the gateway then publishes offline status to the server. So after a while, you can see node 1 will be offline. It takes some time because of the retry count and the polling interval. So on this web page, we have the device ID, the timestamp, and the date, the node status, and temperature humidity value. So now, as you can see, the node status changed from active to offline. And suppose we power it on again. After a while, like very soon, as soon as the gateway pulls it for the first time and receives value, it will update the information as active. So now, as you can see, it is active again. Whatever we have learned in the past few months, we have tried to implement as much as possible in this project. Starting from the nodes, the code, the C code is relatively simple. We, as I said before, the job of the node is to accept some request from the gateway and then respond accordingly. So for that, we are using UART interrupts. And also, we got to know about the ZigBee and RS-485 protocols and how to interface with the DHT11 sensor. Now, DHT11 sensor is a very popular sensor in the current market. We interfaced it using the bit dynamic concept, which is basically when you don't have dedicated hardware, you use the software as a driver. So we learned how to interface the sensor and acquire the data. Next comes the gateway. For the gateway, the most essential component is the Linux system programming. And then the multi-threading and synchronization mechanisms, because we are using multiple threads. One thread is for transmission, one thread is for receiving data from the nodes, one other thread is for updating the configurations. So that thread runs every 10 seconds. And also we have used semaphores and signals such that the data is not missed, any data is not missed. And since we are using UART, so we had to use UART application programming, and also we are displaying all of that data on the onboard LCD. And we also got to know about the MQTT protocol. Now, next comes the remote configuration with Android app. For that, we learned the Python programming. So I made a simple Python script which will update the configuration file as soon as it notices any change in the server. And we use Java for app development, Android app development. And we also got to know about the Google Cloud, the Firebase real-time database, which is a very fast database. That's why it's called real-time. And also we learned about the MySQL database concepts, the queries, and how to make queries from the C program. So I'm very thankful, masters, and it is because of the easy availability of these evaluation boards, continuous support, I was able to make this project a reality. Thank you.